So I just wanted to talk about, thank you. Yeah, just talk about aligning oneself with different levels of vibration. And, you know, I like listening to classical music because it attunes me to a higher vibration. I particularly like, you know, Dr. Hawkins mentioned, there's a track, Alleluia, by Robert Gass, which is one of the things I listen to a lot. And remember, here's the thing, that when you're vibrating at different spiritual vibrations, like everything, like the whole universe and the whole world and how life unfolds depends on the vibration you're at.
Yeah.
So when you're in these high vibrations, you go into these flow states where it's like the whole universe synchronizes in a beautiful oneness and flow throughout the day, where everything is beautifully unfolding throughout the day. And when I first started getting into the spiritual, and you know, things like horror movies where people are killing each other, and also violent video games, and horror movies, also a certain movies where they're very ego-based with a lot of violence as well, and also certain types of music. There are certain types of music which is very kind of, I'm going to get in trouble on this video, but there's certain types of music which is, should I say, I don't know, gangster type music, not trying to be against any type of music, but certain types of music which are really get you into a kind of frenzied ego mode.
Yes.
I mean, like adrenalized, frenzied, like, you know, I could beat you up, and you know, I'm you don't mess with me kind of stuff. So there's certain types of things. So, but they tune me in. I realized, of course, and through the research that has been done, they tune me into, as I start to watch that stuff and get hooked into the hypnosis of these musical bands and these horror images, that I get my consciousness gravitates to a lower field of consciousness.
Mm.
And what I noticed, as I was getting to these high spiritual states, like I'd have these wonderful days of flow, where everything is just unfolding beautifully, and you know, the bus is arriving on time, and then I'd watch one of these movies, you know, with a lot of violence, a lot of action, and a lot of grotesque scenes, which my ego would like.
Mm-hmm.
And then I'd be, and then what would happen is like the rest of my day and the next day would be like, everything would be going wrong.
Mm-hmm.
I'd be missing all the buses. Then suddenly, like, you know, I'd be getting letters through with horrible letters, like you owe money or, you know, everything. And people would be responding to me in a negative way.
Mm-hmm.
People I get on well with, you know, just after I'd watched a bad movie.
Yes.
So then I realized, like, once you get into these flow states, I realized, not because my ego would still like that, but I can't do it now, because I know, like, I'm having a lovely day, and if I do that, either the rest of the day or tomorrow, everyone's going to be horrible, I'm going to miss all the buses, I'm going to, you know, I'm going to overpay for something and realize, or I've lost my wallet, and all of that, I noticed that. So it's like, you know, when you're in these high spiritual states, just to watch something or listen to something that severely disconnects you, I'd lose the grace, you know. So then it's like, well, I want to, like, continuously, like, I want to be in days of flow, where the whole universe is, like, on my side,
and to give
service, to be of love, and to be in those vibrations, and it's like, it's a positive spiral, and the universe takes care of me, I meet people, I have lovely interactions, everyone is, like, looking after me, buses are running to, and it takes so much work to get and stay in those fields, and then, like, you get a thought, well, why don't you watch that horror movie?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
And then it's like, no, but the last time I watched a horror movie, the whole next day was, like, horrible.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so you want to keep those high vibrations, and even if you get those thoughts, once you're in those good places, you don't want to, you get burnt. If you do that, then you lose, you know, the next few hours, the next day, you can be, like, totally off. So it's not worth it. Now, if every day you're watching horror movies and eating donuts, then that's what you're used to every day. So it's like, it's, another day is just the same as what you're used to. But once you get to these high vibrations and you experience days of flow, then it's pretty horrific to go from that to watch a movie and then suddenly have everything go wrong. So that was just my experience. So once you do all this spiritual work, when your ego wants to disconnect you violently, you realize you will lose the grace mm-hmm. and the flow and the sync with the universe.
Mm-hmm.
So, and also, this is me, but I really like to stack things in my favor. I like to listen to music, which will put me in a good place. Yeah. I like to go to spiritual events, but I generally like things which I can attune to that will take me as high as possible. You know, so if I think, you know, like I'm sure, like Mozart, if I have the choice between Mozart and the Rolling Stones, it's like intuitively I know that Mozart is going to give me a better day. The Rolling Stones or gangster rap music. So it's like, or do I spend an hour because my teacher Muji is in London and go see him? Or do I watch the football, or do I play a violent game on my computer? You know, but it's like, well, it's like, you know, so now it's like I want to like be in the fields of grace and love and not disconnect. And the price is quite severe. Once you get into these high states, it's really quite a severe thing to allow yourself to get disconnected because you get very negative ramifications.
Mm-hmm.